Hello, good day, and welcome to the Acer channel. Today we'll be having a look at another product that is for sale from us. It is the RTS DV3140UV. Before I start, I just want to say that RTS is not a specific brand. It is rebranded in South Africa, similar to what Zartec do. They find products overseas which they obviously test and feel that can compete in the market, and they rebrand it as a RTS product or a Zartec product. There are many of these brands out there, so it is not specifically a brand on its own. It is a rebranded product, so it is not anything like a Kenwood or a Motorola, but it is a brand which is only known to them, which they obviously test, put it through their paces, find and that they are happy with it, and then rebrand it under their own name. Nevertheless, the RTS DV3140UV seems to be a dual band handheld portable radio. It is a CASA type approved radio, as you can see, and let's have a look at it. One of the early products that they sold in South Africa was called a Frotvark. Now, a Frotvark is a warthog. It's the Afrikaans word for warthog, and they use the same branding on this device, which is also Frotvark. That is a lot of two-way radios I remember that we sold branded with Frotvark. Frotvark, of course, is a warthog, which is a tough animal and very difficult to kill because it's so tough. And I think that's why RTS opted for that name of Frotvark, because they want to show that their products are tough. At the back, you can see two battery pins. And you can see that the split that this device will cover will be 136 to 174 and 400 to 474. It is a dual band, so it'll do both at the same time. And it is a 5 watt. I doubt that it'll do 5 watt on UHF, but it is spec'd at 5 watt on there. The battery latch at the bottom, as I've mentioned before with other devices, I don't specifically like this. That's just a personal opinion. This is an out-of-box review, so I'm not bad-mouthing anything or any product. I'm simply having a look and giving a comment on what I see. I don't like that for reasons described previously. If you do drop the device, there is a chance that that will break and not be good enough to hold the battery in place. That is just my critical view on that. Out of experience, I know that that has a problem. The latch being on the top is good. I also don't like the fact that the belt clip is on the battery. If the clip fails, or that clip fails, the belt clip is on there, the radio can break away with the battery remaining on your side. That is a critical look at the belt clip design, which I have mentioned on other devices as well, not just limited to this device. There are some others. The radio seems to be turned on while putting the battery on. The antenna, as far as I understand, will be a dual band antenna. Let's see if there's anything written on it. Yes, it says it's a dual band antenna, SMA dual band antenna. So you can use an external antenna to get more range. You can put the antenna on there. It is a long antenna, longer than the radio. The radio fits nicely into my hand. Has a few, two knobs, longer center one and a shorter one on the side. Once again, some of the other manufacturers have a raised little edge here, so you don't damage that knob when it gets dropped. I suppose they have investigated this and found that this is sufficient. If you look at the shape of the knob, thicker in the middle than at the top, so maybe that's how they compensate for that. When you switch it on, the battery voltage shows you that there is sufficient power in the battery, and also you can see the little battery icon there. It is programmed with a bunch of frequencies on. I do not know how many frequencies they come with. Out of the box, this is what you get. It seems like there are some frequencies on there. You can go up or down, probably in a menu of some sort. This review is not to look at the functionality of the device though. It is just a simple look at what you find when you get the radio out the box. There seems to be settings there which you can scroll through once you hold it in. I'm not going to look at this as this is a review for out of the box. This is not a functionality review. Okay, on the side we see that there is audio and microphone socket connections. It seems to be Kenwood style. So yeah, lots of accessories available out there. On the side there is a PDT button with two side buttons below that. It has no emergency button. However, I think that this first button here is an alarm, because if you hold it long enough, it says alarm. It shows that it's transmitting, which I then believe is a alarm function that has built into it. It seems to be quite a nice function. I will put the brochure, screenshots of the brochure in maybe the description at the bottom, where you can download it or at least view it, but that'll be available. Let's have a look at the charger. In the box we see that there is a charger which says at the bottom, when the charger is waiting, nothing happens. Pre-charge, red, and when it's fully charged, it is green. It uses a 12 volt input, which I do like for the reasons I've mentioned before. It is a common connector which is easy to find, so it is quite easy to make your own car charger or like a solar site charger or something like that. It's not a weird voltage. Also easy to make yourself a charger like this. It has a nice design. It seems to be thick enough slots, not like some of the other devices with small little slots. If we look at the transformer, once again, I hate these two pin things, but yeah, it's supplied with a 500 milliwatt 12 volt unit. I don't like this, as mentioned before. It seems to be a standard on everything these days. Nevertheless, let's get closer to the wall socket. There you go, and see what it does when you switch it on. Yes, I like that. It comes on for a second or so to show you that there is power. So if I pull it out, put it back in again, you will see, let's give it some time to just die down. It comes on for a second or so. I like that. You immediately know that the charger is functional, there is power, especially if you've used the core to make your own DC charging cable inside the car. Easy to charge. Just put it in, light comes on. It's very difficult to get it in wrong. It without effort, it slides in a very nice fit. Sits nice and snug in the charger. The red indicates that it's busy charging, and it will go to green when it's full. I like that. Very good function, very nice. If we look at the device, it has a display, and I can see that the microphone is there, making a carry case very easy, not being difficult. Has some buttons on the front. Like I say, this is not a function review. It is a review to see the outer box and just get the feel of the device before you buy it or even suggest to your customer. There you go. I think that's sufficient. What else was in the box? I see there's a little carry strap, typical from most of the manufacturers, as well as the belt clip. The belt clip being a plastic belt clip with a metal part there that screws onto the battery there. As mentioned before, I am not crazy about that idea. I suppose they have done their research and found it to be okay. The belt clip has got a little hook, so it does not slip off of your belt. Once you've hooked it on your belt, it is difficult to just simply accidentally pull it out. So there you go, guys. Thanks for watching. This is my review on the DV3140 RTS radio, also branded Fratfark, which is similar to what we had in the beginning from RTS. They also branded this Fratfark, giving you a sense that this is a robust radio, and it'll last long because it's tough. There you go. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and to get the updates. Have a look at these. Please feel free to share them, subscribe, and you're welcome to comment in the bottom.